In this video, I'll show how about 10 gallons of charcoal was made in just over 45 minutes using a cone-shaped pit. When done right, there is hardly any ash left over, but a lot of very long-lasting, stable carbon for the garden soil. The dirt dug from the pit was used to build up around the edge, which reduced the amount of digging needed to reach my target depth. Should be about twice as wide as it is deep. Can of course be scaled up or down according to individual needs. I start with small sticks at the bottom and then gradually increase the material size as the pit is filled. The largest branches will be at or near the top. This branch was installed along the side of the pit like so. When I think the wood is all carbonized, the stick will be pulled out and checked. I expect it to be charred on the bottom end when the batch is done. Both the upper and middle sections of this indicator stick are covered with soil because the fire will be burning from the top down to the bottom. If the bottom of the stick is carbonized when it's removed and checked, then I assume the rest of the pit is done also, which means it'll be time to put out the fire. Some leaves and small sticks are sprinkled over the pile to help the fire spread quickly over the top surface. A small amount of leaves is mounded up on the wood to help light the pile. I try to keep the feedstock below the edge of the pit to help protect the hot coals from oxygen. Alright, here we go. With this particular method, I only add a few sticks at first to help get the fire going, and then it's allowed to burn down on its own, only stirring if needed. There is no smoke, so I assume combustion is fairly clean and efficient. After the fire has died down quite a bit, there were spots that started ashing over. A handful of sticks helps to stop ash formation in those areas. Almost forgot to add some of these partially burned pieces from previous batches. They're dried out around the edge of the fire first and then pushed in. At this point, I'm only adding fast burning feedstock to keep the fire going since the batch is almost ready, and I don't want to pull out any more unburned material than I need to after dousing the flames. Due to poor planning, I ran out of fast burning fuel and couldn't quickly find much, but I think it's about done anyway. So out comes the indicator. Not even charred. Oh well. The charcoal is ashing over and I'm out of sticks, so the hot coals are put out with water to stop the charcoal from turning to ash. Too early according to the indicator stick, but it's been burning for about 45 minutes and I'm sure there will be a lot of good biochar. I filled the pit higher this time. Looks like more will fit though. As usual, there are some unburned pieces to sort out, but I'm pleased to see that it's mostly charcoal. I'm not sure how much of this pile would be considered biochar as opposed to fuel-grade charcoal, similar to the lump charcoal I use when grilling. That kind of charcoal is, from what I understand, generally not as beneficial for microbes as biochar can be, but it's still valuable carbon for the soil. The quality of this biochar clearly suffers from my decision to extinguish the coals early. I think that another 5 to 10 minutes of burning would have been about right. I'll make sure to have plenty of small sticks on hand next time. After sorting, there was about 10 gallons of charcoal left over. Only about 1/3 of this partially carbonized wood is from this batch. If you're interested in biochar, or would like to learn more about how it can benefit your garden, check out the resources in the video description below. Thanks for watching.